All this faking got me feeling out my element. If you ain't lived through it, don't embellish it. If it ain't the truth, it's irrelevant, it's evident. We here to cut the spokes off that bull that you peddling. Ain't no White House, heaven is my residence. We the lighthouse, Yeshua the president. Hit the block where the gospel ain't never been. Living water blowing out the trunk like an elephant. This cross ain't for studying, boy, you know what's up.
You know what's up.
If it's God over money, then you know what's up.
You know what's up.
I'm praying for the hood like the motor stuck. Take it to my godfather, get your homie tucked. Made a shit, God was a stick, so you know he clutch.
Yeah. I see the love is gone where they put it at. This world so cold, I think I need a knitted cap. And a bubble goose with a bigger gap. Bubbling the truth, so what you think of that? Chain breaking about that soul winning, really though. They ain't really with it, that's just in they video. Say just what I want, I'm a cheat, you don't hear me though. Got life, but ready to die like I'm Biggie though. It's got over money, but money's a tool. Might go to jail if you don't go to school. Young black and Latinos across the whole nation, they standing up corners just holding they jewels. So they're confused, don't know what to do. Know that they lose, don't know that they fools. I show them the rules, I'm holding the news and tell them they value is more than they shoes. Get your life up on the move, Christ the road to choose.
Up is bogus, the lust for showbiz and disgusting motives made them put a price on their souls, and for a few bucks they sold it. Now they take the truth and they stretch it like they instruct aerobics. They make it look like all the sin is cool, they corrupting your kids. We must expose it like lots I'm loaded in the cannon of scripture. I clutch is just explosive, it's no bombs that Russians hold it. Listen up, the goal is to use this cannon to adjust their focus and point to the one that can save their souls from destruction, your bitch. I pray when they hear this track, they'll do more than cheer and clap. I pray they see this picture clear as Miramax. So the snares that track the spirits, which is tearing snack. We spit them lyrics that appears to cats with the spears and pack and mash on these rappers, cause the youth don't need to hear this crap. This cross ain't for stunting, boy, you know what's up.
You know what's
hit
up.
Hit this God over money, then you know what's up.
You know what's up.
Hey, Omega, twist my fingers and I throw it up. Style where I be my clique, we keep the serpent in the cobra clutch.
All right, so welcome back to In The Light. We traveled a good distance for this one also, as you see, it's a whole different backdrop. I'm here with Papa-san, you know, we're in his studio. This is where the magic happens. This is where the ministry flows. Now, we caught up with him before, as you know, and we caught up with him with the album launch. But now we've seen the result of the album and how effective it was. Now, this is an album that went number one, Billboard Gospel Reggae Charts. Now, that's unheard of in gospel music, and that's something I appreciated a lot. It showed me that you can't confound God, you can't hold him in no box. So, you know, I caught up with him to see what's next, because clearly if that was so good, I know a lot of persons would be expecting more. And I wanted to know what was the result of all of that happening. So, Papa-san, give him a shout now.
Bless up, Jamaica. One love. God up every time. Yeah.
All right, cool. So, son, the album, major success.
Yes, sir.
And I know that I've seen you do, even at the album launch, I've seen a lot of those songs minister.
Yes.
Even like One Blood, the first time we heard it at all was at that album launch.
Yes.
And it was resounding. You know, persons are really appreciated what you were saying, especially the fact that it was with Stitchy. And
right.
But you collab with a whole lot of other artists that we know about. Tell me about some of those collaborations, like the Lecrae's and everybody else that was on that.
As you say, I call it miracle. You know, I call it miracle. You know, the thing about it is that I see great results from the whole thing.
Right.
Because I've seen where, you know, the rap community get a view.
Yeah.
And what the dance hall is like. Because it's first Lucre go for the dance hall.
True.
You know, Fred Hammond get a nice view of what they do for the dance hall.
Yeah. Right. Mm-hmm.
And then we see the success that came out of it, you know when it hit the Billboard number one and we began to do concerts.
Mm-hmm.
About based on the project tour and stuff like that, and see how people react to it.
Right.
You know, it's amazing, and just what God can do. And see where, you know, don't give up the fight.
Right.
You know, songs like that.
Yeah.
You know, from in Ghana, you know.
That was interesting. Explode
in Africa.
Yeah.
And we have seen in Uganda several songs on this album, you know, like Step Up and The Truth, Get Right. You know,
yeah.
That we did. I mean, those songs just take off.
They did.
In different years. So you have songs that lick different countries for whatever reasons.
Right.
You know, I would say Marvelous, Wonderful. I mean, like Running.
Yeah.
For instance, was number one in Trinidad.
That was
secular and gospel.
I love that song.
Some people love Blessing. Some people love, you know, Nicholas song. Some people love Ryan. I mean, it's just, I would do it. We do it like that simply because we want it to be an album of singles.
Yeah.
Where every artist and minister in their own right.
Yeah. They're not conformed to your style. Yeah.
You know, Ryan Mark have him thing. Sharon have him thing.
Yeah.
Then Fred do him thing. And I believe when we continue to do that, it has set us a more solid platform for us.
That's true.
When we merge ourselves with international artists.
That's true.
The best way we did, because if you check the secular,
yeah,
it's the same result. I mean, Shaggy with Raven, Papa Sam with Lady G.
Yeah.
It's over the years, you find artists collab with artists in order to set a stronger platform and a stronger foundation for the music itself.
Got you. Now that makes sense. That works. We've seen the results and we hear them in different countries. And I know even in Jamaica, we appreciated all of them. That's our album. Yeah. I was rinsing for a while, just playing it back to back. And you don't get tired of it because it's not an album where it's the same sound right throughout. That's something I appreciate. Yeah, every song had like a whole new theme to it.
Yes.
And that was cool. But now you got on, I know, the Church Clothes mixtape.
Yes.
So I saw where it's not like just you invited them, but now you got invitation to do something else.
Yeah.
And I've seen now where the Jamaican sound is almost necessary on a lot of rap gospel albums so far.
You know, I'm telling you, from secular, it's the same thing.
Yeah.
You know, in some way, because the rap, you know, rap get the whole thing from dancehall DJ. You know?
Yeah, that's true.
Started it first.
Historic.
So not a lot of the sounds they will clip out of our music and use them.
Yeah.
They may use some, you know, the secular, they use some jewelry, like, you know, it's them look flying, them look. Them look at samples in music, you know. And, you know, War, Crime, Violence, We Stop with Lacrae. That was me. That was a sample from a song that I did years ago.
For real?
Yeah, that was taken out. And
war, you know, crime, I did not know that was you. Let me tell you who I thought crime, that was.
Violence, Stop. So all those things, that was a song that they clipped out and my son put it together and Lacrae have it. And then we do another song called Fever.
I know Fever.
Which Fever was on the Church Clothes, you know, Church Clothes album, EPK. So, you know, the reggae music merging with the rap community is amazing.
Yeah.
You know, and this is what we continue to push until we can able to build the music to a level. Because I really want to tell the people, you know, I want to keep a meet when I come down to Jamaica, you know.
All right. Let them know.
In Pegasus, I'm coming down for August 1st for Markland event. And I want to keep a meeting probably about the 28th or the 29th, somewhere there.
Okay.
You know, I really want to gather artists together and media. We need to sit down and reason about the aspect of the music and where the music is at. Because a lot of artists still need to be educated.
That's true. And that's needed.
This is concerned because they're still seeing breaking as an artist. You take a person and put him on a stage. We've had this for 30-something years and that don't work.
Right.
It never worked. You know, breaking an artist take more than that.
Right.
You know, it take more than a one-night event or take an artist, put on a stage, or bring an artist with you. No, the solidest platform you can put an artist from is collaboration.
That's true.
It's collaboration.
That stays. That stays for a good
if you're an artist, if you're a younger artist owner, lift the next artist up and let the artist pick you up to bring you. It's amazing.
That's true.
Because everywhere the music goes, that's where you go. That's why everywhere one blood sells. People near Nicholas,
that's
people near Ryan Mark, people near Tiffany, people near all of us, because the fact that, you know, Frederman can bring some pull to it, Israel can bring some pull to it, Lucre is the number one Christian gospel artist in the world, he can bring some pull to it, you know what I mean? And so when people love Lucre, people love Fred, you know, grab it and see the album, you know, they can able to say, okay, so who is this guy right here? So people have to understand this is how we try to be able to get artists out to break.
And that's like a form of discipleship.
Yeah, that's what you have to do. And that's, you know, I mean it long enough to know that.
That's true.
But people have the mindset, they think that
it's bring the them go a stage own, show.
But it never work like that. Never
work like that. All right. So now you hear it. Now I want everybody to be at that meeting if you're a musician. And if you want to know how ministry works, because it's not just an industry to make money. Because sometimes that's not there. But if you really want to know, you know, how the ministry side and how it works and how just to get your ministry out there, that's learn from the vets. That's how I learn. Now, I know you put out two songs. Now, those two songs been going on the airwaves. I know one of them is one that I find very relevant to what's happening now. You're talking about Jamaica. The bleaching. You're talking about the pedophiles. You're talking about a lot of stuff that I'm surprised you still know about being over here. But I guess you stay relevant. Now, that, tell me a little bit about that song and the importance of doing it, giving a Christian's perspective on what's really happening in the Jamaican society. And not just Jamaica, because I realize that's all over.
America,
yeah.
You know, it's all over America. I mean, Jamaica is a land that we love.
Yeah.
And that's home for me all the time, you know? You know, and when they call me to address a certain situation from there and ask me if I could be on the speed meter reading, and them have a couple of artists there, I said, listen, music is just a vehicle. I just want to be able to carry the gospel on it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so God began to impress on my heart about the different issues that we need to address.
Right.
You know, because it's a form of mental slavery. We see black people trying to bleach your skin, you know, taking out the things that within your skin, the pigmentation, what do you call it?
Pigmentation.
Yeah, you know, out of your skin, you know, trying to make it something that God never designed them to be. If you're white, you're white. If you're black, you're black. That's how God designed it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But it's like you're sticking your face in your hand in God's face and say, I don't like the color that you give
me.
You know,
not a different
and
one.
that is dangerous. You know what I'm saying? The Bible says we are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Right.
You know what I mean? Say for love, just love yourself and respect yourself. You know, so we try to address that. The pedophiling is definitely a need to address that.
Yeah.
Because young girls, young kids, you know what I mean, big grown men, you know, getting little young baby girls pregnant is ridiculous. You know, and we as a church, we can't stand back and not say anything.
That's true.
Because when Jesus called us light, it mean that light reveal and light expose. If you lost a coin, you need light to find it.
Right.
So light not gonna have anything in secret. Light gonna expose what is there. If you need to see where the spot is on your shirt or on your pants and you can't see it in the dark, you need to turn the light on to see where the stain is at.
Right.
So you can remove that stain from the clothes. So the thing about it, the Bible calls us salt. Salt is what brings flavor, you know, to an insipid environment.
Yeah.
But salt is what preserved nation from decaying, because they did not refrigerate at those days when they were using salt to allow to have the meat, to preserve the meat so it don't get spoiled. So we're supposed to preserve the nation from decaying, which means the church should not be silent when it comes to issues like these. We need to address them. We need to bring hope in the midst of it. We don't need to condemn, but at the same time, we need to correct, we need to address, we need to instruct, and we need to give them Jesus to show that there's hope. You know, we need to also, those who are hurting, you know, that been through those things, to bring hope and peace and comfort to those people. We can't keep silent in the midst of it. We should not.
Wow. Now this is, you don't get it no better than this. This is somebody who's been through it, somebody who's also been on the other side, you know, promoting some of that wrong behavior, and then God changed that in your life.
Because, you know, at the out there, you know, in the world, flirting, one girl here, one girl there, one girl all over, you know, different girls, and live a very wild life, you know, as an artist, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, that side of the fence was not good, because, you know, how much bed you can sleep in at one time.
Right.
You know, so, you know, when I received Christ, after all of them things, they have to kind of, you have to put them things that, you know, out of your life.
Old man dead.
Yeah, the old man dead with his deeds and move forward with Christ, you know what I mean?
Amen.
So we come to just let the people know, so listen, Christ can make it work if you just seek him.
That's true. All right. So, I see you do a show in New York. I see you where you move. Hands that I can't even count. And that's out of a... That's like, for me, a niche that... We know a lot of Jamaicans are in New York. But the fact that you could still go there and minister the gospel, and persons are still... They're blessed by it. And you see the support. You can't help but notice it. Right. What's that like? Knowing you... Not just, you're a Jamaican artist, and you've been doing, I mean, you've been rocking stage shows from before you became gospel, but what's that like, knowing now that ministry is still there, all those platforms are still there?
You know, I mean, you know, when God gifted you for something, it don't leave, you know.
Right.
And people often ask me, you know, how do you know it's a gift? You know, when it's feed you, when it never leave you.
Right.
That's a gift. You know, if it's something that you're just lucky, or it's just a buck up, or you have the right people around you to make it work, then it's not going to last.
Right.
So I never yet find myself worried about where I'm at in music, or if I'm going to be in music.
Got you.
Because this is how I live. Music is what I live by, you know, in terms of, you know, providing for my family. And I never worry about having another hit song.
Right.
Because I'm a writer. I can write you any period of time. Anytime I can just come up with a song and it hit just like that. I've been doing it for 30 something years. So the thing about it is see how it reacts, how people react to the gospel. The gospel never gets stale. You know, so you go to church a Sunday, you still sing Your Grace and Mercy.
Amen, brother.
Exactly. You know, I give myself away. We still sing that every Sunday, and it's still nice. We still cry tears when you hear those songs. Yeah. It never gets stale because it's gospel.
Right.
And it's the same way with our songs.
Right.
You know, when we go places like New York or anywhere in the world, people still want to hear Smile Again.
Yeah, that's
people
true.
People still want to hear Loving on Me.
People want to hear the songs that resonate with them. Yeah.
People want to hear songs that really minister to them when they're going through certain things.
Yeah.
I can't do a show without doing Smile Again. I can't do a show without doing Step on the Enemy.
Cut, you know,
some shows ago, you have to sing Road to Travel. You have to sing Loving on My Heart. You have to sing Devotion.
Right.
There are different songs that minister to people. You know, and they never get tired of it because it's gospel.
Right.
And I believe that when you're holding a minister, people come and enjoy the event and be ministered to at the same time. You know.
Got you. All right. So, we see the show in New York. We see the two tracks that you put out there to kind of tease the people. So, right. So you have the EPK this summer.
Which is
the album.
And the album is Journey. And, you know, we have about 5 to 6 songs coming out for the summer.
Okay.
You know, and just a couple of singles and videos.
Okay.
You know, so teasers, you know, for the album coming up next year.
All right.
You know, so that's what is in the making. We're almost done.
To be the album?
With you. The EP key.
Okay.
You know, and then we're going to complete the album before the end of the year.
Got you.
You know, because we still probably have 1 and 2 guest artists on there as usual, you know.
Yeah.
And stuff like that. But we're still working within the studio, do what we need to do.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And just giving God praise at the end of it.
Oh, no, I see you working with a Grammy producing. No, that's something for me that must be amazing. To know that the son that you brought, you know, into this world is now the one helping you to produce all of these hits.
He's running the studio from he was 8, 9 years old. You know, I just met Billy studio and I kind of create the environment for him to perfect his craft.
Right.
So from day one, you know, from early out, he was running this Pro Tools.
Okay.
You know, at an early age, and him sit here all the time and hear music and tracks put together. Yeah. See that blood, you know, it's in the blood. And,
see it, man.
You know, before you know it, him just bring up. And now the youth, 2 or 3 albums in the Billboard Top 10 one time, myself, and the Minium and Lucre.
Yeah.
In the Billboard Top 10 one time, that's history for any producer. Having 3 albums in the top 10 of the Billboard, not just the reggae Billboard, the gospel international Billboard chart. You know,
that's
one time, the Cray, myself, and the Minion at one time. Grammys, Doves, I mean, amazing. See the accomplishments, still in school, still young, you know, not even push himself more, but God just opened the door. And I believe that that's how it works, and that's what I've been saying from day one. My son don't have a poster,
right?
Don't have a car.
I realize,
not
somebody, I had to catch
it. It's just God.
Yeah.
You know, I fly the door open and kind of create around me all that I need.
Yeah.
You know, because for years, you know, you're doing songs with different producers, and that's wonderful. But God kind of give me everything kind of in-house.
Yeah.
You know, so I can able to, you know, I don't have to go outside
right.
to get certain things, which I still do because I still have producers
Interact.
That I respect and love and still work with. But right here, I have it all made.
Gotcha.
You know, and that's amazing.
That's a blessing. No. Tell me what can I expect in terms of the sound though. You know I got a loved one blood, but in terms of the EP and probably even the album, like what concept are you really going for?
Dancehall, we have dancehall, we have reggae, we have hardcore dancehall.
Okay.
We have hardcore reggae. You know,
okay.
We have probably 1 or 2 which will not give you a reggae, a dancehall cross.
Okay.
You know, because we still can lead that genre, but majority of the songs are hardcore and dancehall straight up.
All right. Now I have a question for you. It's a question, you know, we've been in South Florida for a bit, just linking up with some artists that we know, and we realize them saying, you know, the sound, they have to go more international, and it's my bridging them still, you know, but I want to hear from the other side, somebody who not leaving that genre alone, that space, that raw, authentic dancehall Jamaican sound. You think that is enough of a barrier for you to deviate from it? In terms of communicating with the audience,
always keep your roots, but you have to learn to widen the aspect of the game.
Got you.
You know, and if you go back to secular, you find out that secular artists did that. You know, depends on, and you have different kinds of artists, and
That's
this is some of the things that people don't understand. you have popular artists, you have boss artists. You have artists that limited to a certain genre of music. You have artists that very wide. You know, so it all depends on where a person plans to really go in terms of their music. If you want to stay grassroots Jamaican and stay there, you know, that's your decisions. And probably you just don't have it in you. You don't feel that, you know, that urge to go the other side. For me, is that we have experienced both sides of the fence.
Right.
Grassroots. But we know that the game can widen more because the music is not for one man, it's for everybody.
Everybody.
And whenever time I do it open for me, it opens for the next person to walk through. That's why, as artists, we literally have to touch everybody to set a foundation, to help an artist.
Right.
You know, in secular, enough artists never even shake my hand, you know, meet them personally. But they do set a foundation for us as artists that we can walk on.
It's the same way with gospel.
You don't
lessons.
Have to shake Shirley Caesar's hand. You know, to know that she paves the way for CC Winans.
Right.
You don't have to, you know, shake BB Winans' hands to know that, you know, he paved the way, you know, for Marvin Winans.
Right.
You know, so, you know, we have to understand that paving the way don't mean have to meet a person personally.
Right.
It's because of the door and the platform that has been set for reggae music. Or dance and music was not in play.
That's true.
You know, in gospel when I got saved, it was only change and a few other people doing their thing. But when Victory album dropped, it really set a platform,
it did.
Not just for Jamaican artists, but for Sherwin Gardner, for Monty G, for Yankee B, for all over the globe. It set the platform for that. So, you know, we have to continue to find ways, you know, how to widen the foundation. And that's why we can't just leave it grassroots. No, we have to kind of touch the international market so that when one person cross over, the next person can go over.
Right.
You know, all of us probably not getting there. We're not going to get there at the same time. But you have to allow a man to go cross so he can help you to come cross. And that's what I saw the game set.
I'm glad I heard it. You know, I'm glad different persons get to hear it from a veteran, somebody who has been through, as you said, both sides, because we've heard both sides, even different albums. But, you know, if that's the leading that the Spirit is leading you towards, follow the Spirit, because that's what knows best. As he says, some person's in another lane, another person may try another lane, but it's all for the glory of God, and that's what's important at the bottom line. So, yeah, I'm glad I get a chance to just wrap it with Papa San. No, we will have different, as I said, interviews with different members of the family, but stay tuned. In the light. We stay in the light.
Bless up.
Preach the word that the Lord has come. Art and done, art and done. Set the legacy there in that time. Life, don't amiss. Yeah, God only. To God be the glory. We are got art and done. Yo, brother, do your verse before me.
Our movements, I know we are that any good we do, I know we cause that. When you pray with story, do not give we no glory. Praise be to Jesus, the real altar. And we not take defense, cause we not fear no pestilence. My team not have no joke, and we not mean the yoke of Christ a straight excellence. The road and we shock it, but sin a soul we put target pan. Yeah, with empty bill full, we still roll Christ pan billboard promote and we market God. When we dep on mission, we not do this, we no recognition. Jeremiah 29:11, we a say God vision. We want this in a man, take a second listen. We a go hard and done, hard and done. Preach the word that the Lord has come. We a go hard and done, hard and done. Learn a legacy, do with that and done. We a go hard and done, hard and done. Disciple of Christ, copy carbon song. Hard and done, hard and done. Make them know, say that we not back down. We a go hard, our Christ, please take me home. Me a represent the man who sit on the throne. Covered under the blood, me spiritual cologne. Rap soul daily, out of the enemy soul. Hear me, bad in a Christ, spiritual Al Capone. Father, Son, Holy Ghost, and them a me back home. Lucifer, me no dark, so no throne, me no bone. For the youth, them will last, and the people where you moan. Time, Christ, cause a God man time. Take back me nation, trample down, cry now. Go hard for the Lord, this strong man me bind up. You ready for the revolution, come join us. Life, make we take it to the street. Tell the world about Christ, because the gospel have to preach. Too much youth are dead, some words, so what have to read. Right now, your whole kingdom under. We have got hard and done, hard and done. Preach the word that the Lord has come. We have got hard and done, hard and done. Left for legacy, from my daughter and home. We have got hard and done, hard and done. Disciple of Christ, a copy carbon tone. We have got hard and done, hard and done. Make them know that me now back down. Yo, to God be the glory. Take me
me life, me a preach Christ's story. Set example for the youth and before me. For the Lord, me go hard, cause me want to be holy.
For the gospel is shameless, and we don't even care if you know what our name is. We praise him, don't take praises, cause we just wanna make him famous.
Me a go hard and done, hard and done.
Preach the word that the Lord has come.
Hard and done, hard and done.
Set the legacy for when that our son.
Hard and done, hard and done. Disciple of Christ, a copy carbon tongue.
Hard and done, hard and done.
Make them know that me now back
done. We are go hard and done, hard and done. Preach the word that the Lord has come.
We are go hard and done, hard and done.
Let our legacy for me that our son.
We are go hard and done, hard and done.
Disciple of Christ, a copy carbon tongue.
We are go hard and done, hard and done.
Make them know that we now back done. Now back down.
Now back down.
Now back down.
Now back down.
Now back down. Now back down. Now back down.
Now back down.
Now back down. Now back down.
Yeah. When I drop the top and I'm exposing my car to the ozone and stars, it's only because I wanna get closer to God. It's all to the R and sweet, you're totally R.
So me keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. What a God's ways, what a God's ways, what a God's ways, over and over again. So me keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. What a God's ways, what a God's ways, what a God's ways, over and over again.
You don't have a God like mine, or a God like mine. You will never understand why I wait on the Lord like I'm on a standby flight. I'm in love with him with all of my soul and my mind. No homo, but what a man's way. Him touch me, but I worry if another man do it. The love ya bigger than the love between my mother and me and Adam and Eve.
So we keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. What a God's ways, what a God's ways, what a God's ways, over and over again. So we keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. What a God's ways, what a God's ways, what a God's ways, over and over again.
Cause when I wasn't good, him say it's all good. And when I wasn't right, him say it's all right. And if your boy puts it like a jigsaw, I never come across loving like this, so nice. No homo, but what a man's way. Him touch me, but I worry if another man do it. The love ya bigger than the love between my mother and me and Adam and Eve.
So me keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. What a God's ways, what a God's ways, what a God's ways, over and over again. So me keep falling in love with him over and over and over and over again. What a God's ways, what a God's ways, what a God's ways, over and over again.